Dear reader, I'm Tony, and this is Book Text. I took a little break last year to go back to graduate school. If you remember, I already have a master's degree in English, but I'm getting another master's degree, and this time the program is called Instructional Psychology and Technology, which is, you know, a mouthful, but it basically means, hi kitty, it basically means that I'm studying the science of how people learn, and then investigating solutions for teaching and educational practices to best meet learners where they are. I also started working this year as a children's librarian at the local public library, and I'm loving that. I work there on nights and on the weekends. Now that I've found a fairly healthy work-life balance, I'm ready to return to BookTube, but I am going to simplify things quite a bit for myself. So this year, I'm going to be mostly focusing on middlebrow literature. I might be mentioning a few things about my research. One of my research interests is reading as a form of non-formal education. For much of history, many women could only learn through reading. Schools were not accessible to them. And yet we've continued this tradition through book clubs and reading circles is what they were called historically. And so I might share some findings from my research into reading circles and learning communities. I might even extend that to the present day and make some arguments in my research that BookTube and Bookstagram and BookTok are forms of learning communities. And so that's something I'm interested in. I might share some of my findings because I think some of you might be interested in that as well. If you're not familiar with middlebrow literature, you're in for a treat. So the term middlebrow has usually been used to refer to literature or art. Obviously, I'm looking mostly at the literature aspect of it, but literature that brings highbrow, or read that as upper class, culture to the middle classes. And so it was often criticized by the highly literary writers as being more of a commercial endeavor and for being successful that way. But I like to see how the inaccessible parts of culture were you know, brought to more people. So that more people could think about these challenging themes packaged into readable books. I see middlebrow literature as a step towards democratizing literature and art and culture, which is to say, bringing it to everyone, making it reachable for everyone. So I plan to spotlight some middlebrow authors this year and do maybe a little bit more of a lecture style than some of my previous BookTube videos. My focus will primarily be on early 20th century authors in the middlebrow area, but I think there's some modern middlebrow writers that are worth looking into. Again, this was where women were drawn in their reading because it was still challenging, but often cheaper and more accessible, more understandable. As far as reading goals go, I've set a few simple, reachable goals for myself in 2022. Among them are to read 12 middlebrow books this year, and I have several lined up already, to read 50 books total. That will be quite a challenge with my school schedule and teaching schedule and library schedule. But speaking of the library, my third goal is to read more spooky and mystery middle grade novels because I am currently updating our book lists for those genres. So I need to find some of the newer books to add to those lists as we update. That's it from me today. I hope you're having a wonderful new year. And I'll see you in the next video.